السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. On behalf of the Office of the Imams, the Education Committee and the Reciters, we'd like to thank everyone for coming out and attending this special gathering. Inshallah, we have a very exciting program laid out tonight. We'll begin with Quran recitations by some of the local community Huffaz, followed by Sheikh Muhammad Badawi, who will recite and then demonstrate some of the different speeds of Quran recitation. We'd also like to welcome Sheikh Hussein Dalvi from South Africa, who's joining the community as principal of An-Nur Quran Academy. Inshallah, he will also recite and then demonstrate the Quran in some different narrations or riwayat and speeds as well. We'd like to remind everyone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-A'raf, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. When the Quran is being recited, be silenced and listen to it attentively so that you may receive mercy. So we ask that everyone listen attentively throughout the event, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حميم. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم. غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد. كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب. وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أن إنهم أصحاب النار الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم. ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم. اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. Inshallah, the next reciter we're going to listen to is Abdullah Ali.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما صدق الله العظيم.
تكبير. جزاك الله خيرا عبد الله. Inshallah, the next reciter we're going to be listening to is Brother Nabil Rahman.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أكثر الناس ولو حرصت بمؤمنين وما تسألهم عليه من أجر إن هو إلا ذكر للعالمين وكأين من آية في السماوات والأرض يمرون عليها وهم عنها معرضون وما يؤمن أكثرهم بالله إلا وهم مشركون أفأمنوا أن تأتي تأتيهم غاشية من عذاب الله أو تأتيهم الساعة بغتة وهم لا يشعرون قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة أنا ومن اتبعني وسبحان الله وما أنا من المشركين وما أرسلنا من قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم من أهل القرى أفلم يسيروا في الأرض فينظروا كيف كان عاقبة الذين من قبلهم ولدار الآخرة خير للذين اتقوا أفلا تعقلون ولدار الآخرة خير للذين اتقوا أفلا تعقلون حتى إذا استيأس الرسل وظنوا أنهم قد كذبوا جاءهم نصرنا فنجي من نشاء ولا يرد بأسنا عن القوم المجرمين لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب ما كان حديثا يفترى ولكن تصديق الذي بين يديه وتفصيل كل شيء وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون
اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. May Allah make us among the people of the Quran. Allahumma ameen. Inshallah, next we'll be listening to Brother Ali Hida.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وأوحي إلى نوح أنه لن يؤمن من قومك إلا من قد آمن فلا تبتئس بما كانوا يفعلون واصنع الفلك بأعيننا ووحينا ولا تخاطبني في الذين ظلموا إنهم مغرقون ويصنع الفلك وكلما مر عليه ملأ من قومه سخروا قال إن تسخروا منا فإنا نسخر منكم كما تسخرون فسوف تعلمون فسوف تعلمون من يأتيه عذاب يخزيه ويحل عليه عذاب مقيم حتى إذا جاء أمرنا وفارت النور قل نحمل فيها من كل زوجين اثنين وأهلك إلا من سبق عليه القول ومن آمن وما آمن معه إلا قليل وقال اركبوا فيها بسم الله مجريها ومرساها إن ربي لغفور رحيم صدق الله العظيم.
Inshallah, next we'll be hearing from our Sheikh Muhammad Masbah Badawi. He is going to recite and then he's going to explain and demonstrate some of the different styles or some of the different speeds of Quran recitation, which is the reason we named this event Levels of Tilawa.
There's a lot of sweet here, so I don't know what we're going to do now. MashaAllah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدٌ مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريد الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد قال قرينه ربنا ما أطغيته ولكن كان في ضلال قال لا تختصموا لدي وقد قدمت إليكم بالوعيد ما يبدل القول لدي وما أنا بظلام للعبيد صدق الله العظيم.
The goal was to go another turn for a slower recitation, or actually a little bit faster, not slower, because this is the slowest among all the recitations. As you heard from the beginning, from our beloved student, Hamza Ansari, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him a righteous family, Allahumma ameen, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect him and make him a coolness for his parents, Allahumma ameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all the family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and bless the family with the Quran that they have. Allahumma ameen. So the recitation that Hamza start with is called qira'a, a recitation of mudawwar. Let's be agree upon the three different level of recitation, because a lot of people, they have misunderstand what's mujawwad and what's murattal, and what's the difference between qira'a mujawwada and qira'a murattala. A few days ago, we've been reciting Surah Al-Baqarah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابَ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِي الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِي. So when you recite the Qur'an, or if you've been gifted by the Qur'an from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should recite it in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted to you, to give the right of the recitation. So there is a qira'a muhaqqaqa, which is the slowest speed of Qur'an, and that was by Shaykh Abdullahi, I call him the little Shaykh, Abdullahi Ali. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also protect him, Allahumma ameen, and bless his family with the Qur'an, Allahumma ameen. So Abdullah, he was reciting the first level of qira'a, which is the slowest among all the qira'at. Then we moved to Hamza. He recited the qira'a is called mudawwara. Muhaqqaq means that you've given the right for each and every letters, and you slow with each makhraj, the exit of the Qur'an. This is what tahqiq, give the right for each ghunna, which each ahkam, each rules, you're given the right of it. And you take your time of pronouncing each letters and each rules of the qira'ah. This is called qira'ah muhaqqaqa. I give the right of it. حَبَّرْتُهُ لَكَ تَحْبِيرًا, as Abu Musa al-Ash'ari was mentioning to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I know that you are behind me, I was beautify my qira'ah. And this is how we beautify our qira'ah, to read it a little bit slower than the second level, which is mudawwara, that we read in the salah. The salah has been recited, as we says, a little bit faster from the muhaqqaq. And some people has different level of maqamat, different layers of voice. Some people recite with kurd, some people recite with hijaz, some people recite with nahawan, some people recite with sika. MashaAllah, we have our dear Sheikh, he's more knowledgeable than me. Sheikh Hussain, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yani allow him to give us some benefit, inshaAllah, when it comes to his turn, inshaAllah ta'ala, about this, inshaAllah ta'ala. So there is another, the third tilawa is the qira'ah al-munhadira, al-muhdara. And this is the faster qira'ah. So we have three now, muhaqqaq, and mudawwar, and hadr. All of them is called mujawwad and murattal. All of them. So I listen today to qira'ah mujawwada. I listen today to qira'ah murattala. Rather is a muhaqqaqa, or mudawwara, or muhdara. Muhdara, this is for yourself. When you have the Qur'an by your own and sitting in the house, sitting in the masjid, you recite in Qur'an, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm al-Din, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in, Uhdina s-sirata al-mustaqim, s-sirata al-ladhina an'amta alayhim, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين, Ameen, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب, and so on and so forth. You keep going with the Qur'an. This is the faster level of recitation of Qur'an. But I didn't miss any rules of qira'ah. I kept making ghunna, I kept making mad, I kept making the iqlab and ikhfa, and all the rules of tajweed remain the same. But the tune of my speed is I'm speeding or I'm slowing. So all the Qur'an has to be following the rules of ahkam and the ahkam of tajweed, and take your time without missing anything. I'm not reading newspaper. I'm reading the Qur'an. What's the difference between the Qur'an and any textbook? It is just to apply the rules of tajweed. So this is what you listen from our dear beloved students, Hamza and Abdullahi, and also Nabil and Ali. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of them. Allahumma ameen. And I'm not going to take too much time from your time, inshallah. And I will leave the mic to my beloved Sheikh, Sheikh Hussein. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him the tawfiq, inshaAllah ta'ala.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه. بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان. يسأل أيان يوم القيامة. فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا بك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة ولو ألقى معاذيره لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانا كلا بل تحبون العاجلة وتذرون الآخرة وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة ووجوه يومئذ باسرة تظن أن يفعل بها فاقرة صدق الله العظيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بل قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة ولو ألقى معاذيره لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانه كلا بل تحبون العاجلة وتذرون الآخرة وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة ووجوه يومئذ باسرة تظن أن يفعل بها فاقرة كلا إذا بلغت التراقي وقيل مراق وظن أنه الفراق والتفت الساق بالساق إلى رب بك يومئذ المساق فلا صدق ولا صلي ولكن كذب وتولي ثم ذهب إلى أهله يتمطي أولي لك فأولي ثم أولي لك فأولي أيحسب الإنسان أن يترك سدى ألم نك نطفة من مني تمني ألم يك نطفة من مني تمني ثم كان علقة فخلق فسوي فجعل منه الزوجين الذكر والأنثى أليس ذلك بقادر على أن يحيي الموتى
بلى إنه ولا كل شيء قريب بلى وقادر صدق الله العظيم.
جزاك الله خيرا شيخ حسين بارك الله فيك. إن شاء الله finally we will have our beloved Imam Abu Talib deliver a short talk pertaining to the Quran and he will wrap up with a closing dua inshallah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الله أسأل أن ينور قلوبنا وبيوتنا ومسجدنا بنور القرآن. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى to bring the light of the Quran into our hearts and our homes, our community and our masjid, to bless our teachers and those that taught us the recitation of Al-Quran and our beloved shuyukh and huffaz that have shared this beautiful recitation with us tonight. Just to share with you a short reminder for dua inshallah. This narration comes about an incident with Al-Quran Al-Kareem for some of the companions with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The narration comes in Sahih al-Bukhari. عن عمر بن مرة عن إبراهيم قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لعبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه اقرأ علي. The authority of Amr ibn Murrah, the authority of Ibrahim, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the noble companion Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, he said, recite to me, meaning recite to me Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. قال أقرأ عليك وعليك أنزل. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, shall I recite to you when it was revealed to you, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال فإني أحب أن أسمعه من غيري. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his humility, with his empowerment of others, with his teaching and modeling, being the best teacher and the best learner, he told Abdullah ibn Mas'ud that I love to hear it, meaning the Quran, from other than myself as well. فقرأ عليه سورة النساء حتى بلغ فكيف إذا جئنا من كل أمة بشهيد وجئنا بك على هؤلاء شهيدا. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud read from the beginning of Surah An-Nisa about 50 ayat, a number of pages of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, until he came to the noble ayah, which means, so behold, when we shall bring from every ummah, every nation, a witness, and will bring you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as a witness over all of them. Qala amsik. فَإِذَا عَيْنَاهُ تَذْرِفَ. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, stop there. When he looked at him, he found his eyes overwhelmed with tears, sallallahu alayhi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This story captures so much, but I wish to highlight a couple things for us to move with the energy and the blessing of this night to our homes and our families. First, Al-Quran Al-Kareem for the generation of the Sahaba, and in fact, Asad mentions this in his commentary on Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem as one of the three main differentiators between the generation of the Sahaba and later generations. He says that when the Sahaba read Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, they read it for change and transformation. They read it for application and guidance. And many later generations read the Qur'an for barakah. Meaning, we read the Qur'an when someone dies, when someone is born, in the occasions, and the Qur'an is full of barakah. The Qur'an is full of blessing. But we do not take that additional step of bringing the meanings of the Qur'an, the applications of the Qur'an, the prohibitions, the commandments of the Qur'an into our lives, so we can feel its transformative impact. SubhanAllah, in this short narration, the emotion, the visual of the Prophet ﷺ's blessed face wet with tears, the awareness of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud of the honor of the moment to be reciting to the one that Allah selected, the Qur'an to be revealed, that all of this comes because we see how real the Qur'an was for them. And wallahi, I see that we have a great blessing in this community. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue it and complete it for us. But we should not take it for granted. SubhanAllah, as I look everywhere in this musalla, there is a blessing in this room that is absent from many communities here and across the world. And we should be thankful for it. Everywhere I look, I'm seeing people that remind me of Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. Not just those that have recited to us, mashallah, may Allah bless them and preserve them. But here I see parents, fathers and mothers that have sacrificed time and money and effort to bring their children closer to Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. Even some parents that may not have had those same opportunities themselves. They opened more doors for their children, mashallah. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ speaks about a great reward for the parents, the people of the Qur'an, that they will have crowns on the Day of Judgment from light that is not like the manufacture of any human hands or any human creation. I see, mashallah, teachers, men and women, and some of our hafidhat, some of our female students, alhamdulillah, have memorized the Qur'an al-Kareem. And others that are continuing in this journey, bringing Al-Qur'an into our households. This is a great blessing, my brothers and sisters, my respected elders, but it is a blessing that should not be taken for granted. It's a blessing that should not be forgotten. The blessing, subhanAllah, of in this community for now almost 20 years, a regular halaqah of recitation of Al-Qur'an al-Kareem after Salatul Fajr, continuing. This is a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The blessing of our high schoolers and some of our younger students that are gathering, learning Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, the Qur'an recitation program in the weekend school, all of these are a wonderful foundation for us to continue and build and develop to higher levels. But ultimately, this is for the transformation that the Qur'an brings into our lives, for its application, for its living. And inshallah, part of our intention is that the person with ikhlas, with sincerity, that rushes to Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, trust me, you can never imagine what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might select one of these children today who are the fathers and mothers of tomorrow, who are the teachers of tomorrow. Some of the huffaz here, mashallah, who I know, it is all of our ambition and all of the teachers, mashallah, their teachers in the audience and their teachers here at my side. I know I speak for each of them when I say that it is their hope that their students, inshallah, one day excel even to higher heights than their own teachers and go on to impact more and affect more. Wallahi, from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll close with this. I think about the people of Al-Quran, just the few of the giants of this ummah that we have been blessed to learn from and to meet and to see. And I imagine the vision of their parents and their teachers bringing Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem into their lives and the heights that they soared later with the blessing of Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. From these people was a Sheikh Amin Siraj. Someone believed in this young man when he was still a boy. He learned Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem as a young child in Turkey. But when he became a teenager and grew up, he was in the height of political conflict in the middle of the 20th century, during a time when they were shutting down all of the Islamic universities and the opportunities to study deen during this tension in part of the 20th century. Subhanallah, first his father, but then several of his family members were jailed, and so some of his teachers had this vision that one day this would change and the people of Turkey would need someone to teach them Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. So with this beginning of the seed of the Qur'an, Sheikh Amin Siraj, as a young man, was sent abroad and learned from Al-Azhar University till he finished his studies, came back in his 20s, having finished Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem along with some of the fundamental Islamic sciences. Subhanallah, he is now in his 80s. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve his health. And when he came back and the conditions changed in Turkey, for 50 years consecutively, he taught at Jama Muhammad Al-Fatih in the center of Istanbul without ever asking for a penny or anything in return, just that his students love to draw closer to Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. Subhanallah, until these years, he still continues the teaching as his health allows. From these great people was a great woman scholar of the 20th century, a Sheikha Umm Sa'd, who grew up in the early 1900s in rural Egypt. She started to lose her eyesight. And it was the habit that in the countryside, you know, they did not have the advanced medical sciences, and so they would treat these as best as they could with kuhl and with herbs, and subhanAllah, the treatment actually made it worse until she fully lost eyesight in both of her eyes. Her parents could have given in. They could have said, she cannot be like her peers. She cannot be with Al-Qur'an. She cannot be with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that high level. But they said the exact opposite. They dedicated her whole life to Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. Actually, from her teachers, was one of the great women scholars of the late 1800s, a Sheikha Nafisa, whose classroom was notoriously difficult to get into. You would have to be a superstar student to learn with her. And initially, she didn't want a Sheikha Umm Sa'd because she felt that so many people with their responsibilities and parents and family and so on, they wouldn't be able to keep up this ilm that they would teach her. But she was very persistent. And as a young student, she studied with a Sheikha Nafisa rahimahullah till she mastered the 10 qira'at of Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. Subhanallah, you log on to YouTube and you think of the most famous reciters, especially of the late 20th century. The most beautiful voices, the most popular YouTube pages, many of the great mashayikh, men and women of the 20th century traveled to Alexandria, Egypt for the blessing of reciting to this woman, a Sheikha Umm Sa'd, who left the spotlight and the fame aside, but taught well into her 90s. Without eyesight, she taught those that could see and read and write for almost an 80 plus year journey with Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took her soul and she returned to Him. Remember, subhanallah, rahimahullah, I remember the blessing of sitting in the classroom of also some of the people of Qur'an here in America. And one of them was from the Indian subcontinent, a Sheikh Javed Bayat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. Subhanallah, you know, Sheikh Badawi, Sheikh Hussain, I was so scared when I sat in his classroom that I made 3 mistakes before I finished the first page of Surah Al-Baqarah. And I had At this time, I had memorized Quran. I was seeking advanced studies, and the Sheikh looked at me. He said, "Son, did you memorize anything of the Quran al-Kareem?" But I was just so terrified to be sitting in his presence. Subhanallah, a person that was given great tawfiq in his masjid, people would sit 5, 6, 7, 8 years old memorizing Al-Quran Al-Kareem. From the products of his classroom were 12 and 14 year olds that led Taraweeh confidently and with few mistakes in front of all the people in Ramadan. These are just a few of many of the people of the Quran in our midst. And our intention, our hope, our reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that our homes and our children and ourselves may be counted among these people inshaAllah today. And so I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bring us guidance and blessings with Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, that He grant us the manners and the etiquette and the application of Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate us in ranks and draw us closer to Him with Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem, to grant us its proper recitation, to teach us its meaning, to grant us living its application in our lives. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open for us the doors of tafsir and its meaning and explanation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the Qur'an an argument for us, not against us. Allahumma ja'al al-Qur'an al-Karima al-Azima rabi'a qulubina wa nura sudurina wa jala'a ahzanina wa dhahaba humumina wa humumina. Allahumma arzuqna tilawatahu ana' al-layli wa atraf al-nahar ala al-wajhi al-ladhi yurdika anna ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma ja'al al-Qur'an al-Karima hujjatan lana la alayna ya rabbal alameen. اللهم ارفعنا بالقرآن اللهم ارفعنا بالقرآن اللهم ارفعنا بالقرآن اللهم بارك لنا في أولادنا بالقرآن ونور قلوبنا بالقرآن ونور بيوتنا بالقرآن ونور مساجدنا بالقرآن يا رب العالمين اللهم يا رب العالمين هذا الدعاء ومنك الإجابة يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم آمين آمين آمين. Jazakumullah khairan, mashallah, for to Sheikh Muhammad Musbah Badawi, Sheikh Hussein Dalvi, our esteemed Hafad, and to the teachers, mashallah, of Al-Nur Quran Academy and Al-Iman School in the audience, alhamdulillah, and to the esteemed parents that have made this possible, to all of the students, mashallah, of Al-Quran in our midst, and those, inshallah, that will continue in this, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them tawfiq and to accept from all of them, inshallah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك السلام عليكم